Hey everybody, it's me, Liz, coming to you live from my mom's kitchen. It is the afternoon, and I'm thinking I need something sweet. And I'm thinking, I feel like making a video, and I feel like making something funky. So I come in, sure, I could do the obvious. I could eat this leftover ice cream cake that a friend gave me from her birthday. It was heart-shaped. It's by Carvel. It's been delicious. The modern take on the Carvel cake now is that they put fudge sauce in there too with those little cookie crumbs. So what I want to do is use some of Mom's Bisquick and make me an ice cream cake pancake. I'm going to melt some of that ice cream. Now a lot of it is crumbles and sauce, so I'm going to make half the recipe. It calls for halving the recipe on the Bisquick box is going to be a cup of flour, is going to be a half a cup of milk, and just like I did when I made my creme fraiche thing, I still needed to use some more liquid because this is cake crumbles. So I'm going to take probably like a quarter of a cup of milk and melt some of this ice cream cake in it till it comes up to a half a cup. Then one egg, whip it up and make a pancake and see how colorful it comes out and how delicious it comes out. And I'll be right back. Okay, that was 30 seconds. I took a little wedge of the cake, got as much of the colorful stuff as possible. That was 30 seconds in the micro. And if you look, we have exactly a half a cup. So I am going to add just a splash of milk to give it a tiny bit more wetness to make up for all those chocolate cakey bits. And whip up my you can tell I'm doing it one-handed today. I'm going to whip up my batter and I'll be back. Okay, I'm back. And as you see, sorry the lighting is so bad. I should really hit a light. Hold on. Well, let me try the shade. I won't have to walk you all over the place. All right, as you see, the color came out a little on the pink side because of the pink in the ice cream stuff, but also because of the yellow in the egg. It really looks more brown than pink. And I'm sure there are little bits of the colored sprinkles in there somewhere in the chocolate chips, but pretty much it looks yucky. And the consistency did not come out nice. I had to use a lot of milk to get it to be that thin. So, and also the Bisquick might have sat on the shelf a little bit open, so I don't know how it's going to turn out. It might taste divine, though, and I hate to waste good ice cream cake, so I'm going to continue by making them festive with blue food coloring. Why not, right? Let's see if I can mix that in with one hand. I think blue... It's possible that blue is just going to make this so much worse. I need both hands. I'm going to make it real blue and then make us a couple pancakes. Be right back. Okay, there we have it. It's blue. And you can see a little bits of the color in there. I don't know if you can see it in this cam. It's under sort of a yellowy... I'm under a yellowy range light. It's no frills videography today between the lighting and the one-handed cam. Just because I'm having my fun. And so it does look blue, maybe a little aqua-y blue because of the yellow and the yolk. I'm pretty happy with it because at first I thought, oh, I wanted it brighter blue. But then I remembered when Tammy Yo-Yo Max 12 made her rainbow bread. Her dough was really dull, but then when it baked, it was really vibrant. So I'm hoping that these are a little more vibrant when I cook them as pancakes. And I don't know, I'm sort of happy with it now. Now that I've got the coloring in there and got it mixed up better, the consistency seems pretty good. And I think we're going to probably get a pretty tasty blue pancake out of it. I think my oil is almost hot enough. Pretty much. They always tell you to wait till you smell it. I don't quite smell it yet. And other people do little testy things where they flick a little of it in there just to see if it sizzles. I'll do it. And there's two little blue pancake turds. I had to say it. I know we try to be polite here at the House of Snarzle, but there you have it. Two little blue pancake turds. Okay, so you know how I hate it when things spill. You know how I like a clean cooktop. Look it, I burned the paper towel. Hey, it's high stakes around here in the Snarzle kitchen. All right, So, now let's try the pancake. Well, that's not gonna do. I need a different spoon, I think. You can just watch the turds while I get the right spoon. It's very rubbery. The dough. I don't think these are gonna be light pancakes, let's just say that. I would almost say because the batter is so thick that I should just milk the heck out of it for the second ones. You know how the first pancakes never come out good anyway? That is one thicko pancake. All right, I'll be right back. I'm gonna thin up my dough. I'll be right back. Okay, there we have it. Two of them connected, one almost shamrock shaped in the pan. The pan got a little hot. I burned a couple of them. Wait, I'll show you. Look at that. Because the pan got too hot, I didn't bother finishing to cook them. But look how cute they are. They're adorable. That one's almost heart shaped. So there we go in the pan. You like the way I spun you around and made you dizzy? That's what it's about here today. It is so humid, I can't even tell you. And I don't even know why I'm standing over a stove. But there you have it. I'm going to flip these. I'm going to put them on a plate. I'm going to tell you how good they taste in just 1 minute. There you have it. As you see, as is always the case with the first batches, before you regulate the heat well, sometimes you burn a couple, although they don't taste burnt. I suspect some of that darker browning is because of the blue color as well. But there's the perfect one. There's the money shot pancake right there. It's very pretty, and I love they all sort of come out with this ring design. Let's have a look at the back. Well, that's kind of neat. Obviously, consistency was a real issue with these. But I tried a piece of the burnt one beside me here that I showed you a minute ago, and they taste like they're fluffy and delicious and taste like regular pancakes. So here's my final word on it. I'm gonna try this one a little bit. I obviously somewhere in here there's gonna be some of those chocolate chippy things unless they dissolved. That chocolate crumble. And there may be a piece of confetti sprinkle in there somewhere. I'm gonna butter it like a regular pancake. I'm not gonna have any food porn at the end because I'm about to eat it, the pretty one. But so hey, another day in the kitchen with me. And I'm gonna try it. My first bite of the other one was that it tasted like regular pancake, and why bother with the Carvel cake? I'm standing in my own light. I'm shadowing. Yes, I'm using cheap Aunt Jemima's and not real syrup. We've discussed my feeling about raw real syrup before. It's delicious, but it's very thin, and you have to refrigerate it after you open it. So unless you heat it up, you're pouring cold sugar water on your pancakes. I like the fake kind. I'm sorry, Canada. I'm sorry, Maine. That is one delicious pancake. It is so good. And it doesn't taste one bit of ice cream cake. The blue color is beautiful. So for me, because I love blue food. So what I would say is next time I would make these, I would make them according to the box instructions, the thickness of the batter that I like, and then I would put some fun food coloring in. And then I would sprinkle my sprinkles in just as it's cooking. Some colorful sprinkles. I'm sure everybody knows this and has done this before, but the point is I was trying to do it with Carvel ice cream cake. So I call it a fail, but I call it delicious and colorful, and I'll see you next time.